All right. Now that we got all the slurs out of the way.
Yes.
That was...
Thank you for allowing that.
Dude, holy shit. I mean, I had to get it out of my system as well, you know?
Yeah, like I said, it's really like a hot bubble inside that it has to pop. And if I keep it in, it's going to pop.
So. Yeah, it was crazy. I mean, you said some stuff that I've never even heard before.
I'm from South Carolina. Very colorful variety of things you can say, actually. Most people don't know. Yeah.
It was wild. Oh shit, we're rolling. We'll probably.
Oh, are we?
Yeah, we'll probably keep that in. It's fine. I think it'll be okay.
Well, not the first part before. Yeah, okay.
Not the part before this, then. But we're being ironic.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
You know, it's just.
It's a satire.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. Good one, dude. Come on. I love doing that. White people.
Right.
It's so cool. Okay. We're here with Super Mega, and they're Super Mega Libs. Fucking got them. Burn.
We are, I wouldn't call myself a lib.
Yeah.
More like I'm a libertarian. We're a big libertarian YouTube channel.
Yeah, big libertarian. They're constantly making videos. You might know them from famous videos like Age of Consent Laws. They should be abolished.
Yep.
What's next?
Well, I think it's wrong, but I don't think it's the government's place to... Right?
What's next? I mean, what are they going to... I can't even think of something worse than that.
Yeah, that's the worst one, probably.
Did you know Alan Dershowitz? Are you familiar with Alan?
The lawyer,
The Dersh? Yeah.
OJ Trump? Yeah.
Jeffrey Epstein?
That's right. That's the big one.
Yeah, Alan Dershowitz once completely unprompted put out a Twitter thread.
Oh, I've seen that Twitter thread.
Defending the 16-year-old girl's right to consent to sex.
Yeah.
Which is very weird when you're, or I guess very on brand when you're Jeffrey Epstein's lawyer and friend.
Close friend, yeah.
Michael Bay did the same thing in like a recent Transformers movie where he had a whole like segment pretty much defending like a certain state's like, actually in this state, you fuck a 17-year-old.
Like
they flashed the law on screen and everything.
What?
That sounds like there's a lot more to that story than what we're seeing.
Because Mark Wahlberg's daughter in the movie was like 17, and then her boyfriend was like 20 something, and the boyfriend had like a card with the law on it, like Romeo. What is it called?
That is so fucking weird. If you have that card, that's a red flag.
Makes what? You, well, the movie frames it as like he's owning like. The father, like, actually,
buddy, he's got it laminated in like a little necklace.
Like,
that is
laminated
also the
card.
Weirdest way. That's like almost worse than fucking his 17-year-old daughter. he thinks he's gonna debate his way out of that.
That's
wow.
Have you ever seen the clip of Machine Gun Kelly?
Seen clips of Machine Gun Kelly? Also, I like what you're doing there, cornering the market and also eliminating the competition.
Yep, that's exactly.
I like that.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, that's smart. Let's pull it up. Can you pull that up, Marsh? Machine Gun Kelly. Was it Kylie Jenner?
Kylie or Kendall?
I think
one of the two.
I brought that up because he has like
that's the one.
Has that stuff ready to go. He has like the list of rock stars that have like 16-year-old girlfriends.
No, the top one is good. Top one's good. That's a good one. Yeah, no, I know.
I love the guitar music with the slow motion, like, psycho stare.
It's like,
I can't be sorry for being young and not listless.
Oh! the lip bite. That's literally mentally the same as the lemonade.
Yeah, that's why I brought it up, because that's the same thing. It's like, yeah.
Excuse me. Look at this card that says I can fuck your underage daughter.
Yeah, Axl Rose dated a 14-year-old.
Didn't mention Jerry Seinfeld, I see.
No, ooh, he didn't.
That's very a good prompt. One. That's a big one.
He brought her to the red carpet and everything. He wasn't ashamed.
Yeah, no. Dane Cook, keeping up the legend.
Isn't that
legend
like a
alive.
Recent thing that he's like getting like shit for?
He's getting married, I think, at the young age of 53 or something.
Yes. Yeah. I saw his stand-up recently at the Laugh Factory, and he made jokes about that. Like digging on himself, and I'm like, okay, but that did you're still.
Wait, is that like a Louis C.K. bit too, where he's like, it'd be weird if I jerked off in front of every female comic I brought up, right? Men are so creepy, and then it's like, oh shit, he did that.
Yeah, no, he was making jokes about it. Great stand-up set though.
Yeah, you like the message.
I went with Minx. We went and saw Dane Cook. Fantastic, fantastic.
I've never heard anyone go, I went to a Dane Cook stand-up. Dane Cook stand-up, and it was fantastic.
Well, you're hearing it now.
That's a first for everything. That
right?
is a first. Yeah. What about it was good? Let's talk about that.
So I actually didn't know he was going to be performing. I just was invited to the Laugh Factory with a group of people, and Ron and I are big Laugh Factory fans.
Is that where we saw Tim Allen?
That is where we saw Tim Allen. Okay. And that's where Kramer...
He said the N-word, too.
I do know that, yes. Okay. I hate the Laugh Factory.
No, Tim Allen said the N-word.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
Well, he said a form of it.
It rhymes with a famous river, right?
No, it was...
the runaway
N-word No. Can I...
Well,
it's not live.
Do you remember exactly what he said?
Yes.
Okay.
Isn't there... Probably this. Isn't there a river called the Tigris River?
The Tigris River?
I think.
The Tigris and
he
like
said that with the N-word?
He did, yes. He was hammered, dude. And we went and it was just conservative stand-up and the crowd was packed and they were eating it up. Dude.
I hate to laugh at
him. He was hammered on stage.
He was like almost blackout drunk.
Do you have a bad experience at the Laugh Factory?
I don't know. I just don't like it. I've always been a Comedy Store fan. I don't know why I like ride for them so hard, but I think it's just like overall better stand-ups.
It's a personal
thing.
Isn't
that Joe Rogan's place, the Comedy
Store? He does
love
the comedy. He loves there and improv.
Okay.
The improv. But
Yeah. We've been to the improv. That's where we met, we didn't meet him, but we bumped into Nick Swardson. Also
it's
very
big
strong.
Name drop episode, by
yeah.
the way.
Yeah.
I love that.
And we know people.
Yeah, let's talk more about all the cool people that you guys met, including, okay. but not limited to, someone you worked with that I don't know anything about.
We have an NDA. We can't...
Markiplier?
Richard Spencer. Oh. Let's talk about it.
He's misunderstood.
Yeah. Milo Yiannopoulos. Yeah. Markiplier.
Yeah.
How is that like? So give me your background. Give me everything because some people are not going to know.
You want it all.
I want bare it all.
We're going to have some Hassan heads watching saying, who the hell are these?
Who are these guys? These funny guys.
Before Matt came into the story, I met Mark because I lived in South Carolina and was doing a sketch comedy thing with my friend Daniel at the time. And then we sent out like an email when Mark had 50,000 subs. I was just like, hey, do you want to do a video? He's like, everyone just asked me to play games. No one's asked me to do a sketch before. So he respected us for that. And mm-hmm. he said yes. And then we just started collaborating.
You guys found Mark before he blew up.
He was blowing up. He was like, at the time he was in that like rise.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we had 50 subscribers, I think, at the time.
Yeah, and then he drove from Ohio to mm-hmm. South Carolina to make a video with you guys, right?
To like collaborate and stuff. And so we had a fun little powwow friendship. He bought me and my friend alcohol when we were underage, got us drunk up in my bedroom, made some fun videos. And then we've eventually moved out to LA because he did, just to edit and like work for him. Matt visits. And we pitched the idea to Mark, it would be great if you had a dedicated Let's Play editor.
Yeah, so I was working at Chick-fil-A, Big Christian.
On brand, go on.
I know. I saw a tweet the other day. I was like, man, everyone that works at Chick-fil-A is a fucking dork. And so many people sent it to me. I still have dreams all the time about it. But basically, he had a sketch comedy channel, Syndigo, with our friend Daniel. And he was working with Mark. And we had a mutual friend, while I was at college, show me their channel. And she was like, oh, they're from South Carolina, too. And I was like, no way. So I think I got in touch with you guys somehow.
You're more close with Daniel.
Yeah, I got in touch with Daniel. And then he saw the channel, and he was like, well, what if you flew out to L.A. and we made some videos?
Because Matt would just send me Photoshop pictures of, like, my family members in porn ads, like, before I knew him.
That's how I was trying to break the ice. It was, like, a picture of Ryan and his stepdad.
Wait, for real?
Yeah. One was my grandmother, who I love very much.
How does that imply that you don't love her? In fact, that implies that you love her.
It was more
very much.
It was more implying that it was a deep cut.
We hadn't really spoken. I would just
that
send
says
those
more
to
about
him.
You that you're still friends with him after that. That worked.
Well, also the first time we met, he took a blowtorch lighter to my arm.
That wasn't the first time we met. That was within the first month.
Okay,
we were at a smoke shop and there was a blowtorch and I was like. Testing, I just kind of did it on his arm, and it just—he
was looking for something to test it on. My arm, I guess, was.
Dude, I was 19.
You have a scar?
No, thank God.
Okay. Well,
no, but he was like,
it wasn't that big.
We didn't know each other that well, and he was like, "Dude, what the fuck?"
Well, it surprised me because I'm like looking at some weed paraphernalia.
Yeah.
Then just it scared me, and I looked, and he was just like, "Oh, oops."
I remember your reaction. I was genuinely like, "Oh fuck, I pissed him off." But basically, yeah, I would just would like take a picture of like him and his grandma, and just replace like the picture in one of those like porn ads on the side of a website, and but you know, something stupid to break
some
the ice.
And gaffes, yeah.
There's a couple gaffes, and he didn't. Reply.
In your mind, how did that play out in your mind? You were like, he's gonna be like, haha, remember when you put my grandma on a porn ad?
That See, that's really how funny. I was. That's
usually how you made friends.
Yeah. So I was like, this has never failed, and it did. But then we got on like a Skype call. And then I booked a ticket and I flew out. And then we hung out.
He was
out.
Like, that's a great porn ad. Fly out to Los Angeles. Get him out here right now. I need more of this.
But basically, then we just started shooting videos together. And during that time, I met the Markiplier, the one and only.
Is it weird that I don't know anything about him? Like, and have never watched
a single
video?
Do you know what
type
of content he does, though?
No.
I think it's sad.
I've never watched a single Markiplier video.
It's never popped up in your recommended.
Never, not. Well, I don't even look at YouTube that much, though, unless I'm on stream.
Okay.
And my YouTube recommended is just fundamentally broken because of all the weird shit I look at on YouTube. It is, like, so far removed from, like, normie content that you see on YouTube. Like, I rarely ever have Mr. Beast videos recommended, or if at all, only when, like, a friend of mine is in a video, you know what I mean? I
feel bad for you,
man. I know Mr. Beast, by the way. Just, like, if we're flexing.
You know Mr. Beast?
Yeah, if we're flexing, like, I got that could on you guys.
Well, he's from North Carolina.
Yeah. Well, they're kind of like.
Hey, we know Carl Jacobs,
we know
actually.
Jacksepticeye.
Yeah.
Okay, cool, whatever.
I was
Me
supposed
too.
To go get dinner with
he's,
him tonight,
He's talked to Ryan Reynolds, who's owner of Mint Mobile, so.
Who sponsors our podcast.
I have no, wait, what, Mint Mogul?
Mint Mobile?
Oh, Ryan Reynolds owns Mint Mobile?
Yes, it's or his company. He owns it.
Big, yeah.
It's what the
and
fuck?
He's a spokesperson.
Yeah. Jacksepticeye, I've never met him in person. I just have.
He's a nice guy.
I just know him over the internet.
The Game Grumps?
Yeah, so.
Another awkward, but I don't know anything about Game Grumps.
We worked for them for 3 years. We edited thousands of Game Grumps episodes.
I shot the Chuckle Sandwich podcast, yeah. Which shoots at their studio.
Okay, yep.
All oh, the way yeah. in fucking freaking, I don't even know. Or is that?
Want to dox them?
Yeah, let's dox them. Fuck it, dude. It's very far away. We can bleep it. All the way in beep.
We know where we've been there, so.
Yeah.
We know exactly yeah. where it is.
But then I stole a bunch of Game Grumps merch when I was there from the warehouse.
That didn't get you interested in maybe watching an episode or no. two?
Why?
I don't know.
Have you watched, it's so honest.
Have you watched no. our Let's Plays?
No.
Well, I appreciate the honesty.
Wait, you guys do Let's Plays?
Wait, yeah.
Yeah.
Not mainly. We do other stuff.
No. Well, so basically, this ties into the story. Worked for Mark for a while. Ended up going on our own and starting Super Mega. We got an apartment together. Started the channel. Then shortly after, Game Grumps was like, hey, we need editors. Do you guys want to edit our videos? And we're like, okay, because we're making no money on Super Mega. Making like 15 cents a day when we first started.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm making about 15 cents a second.
Fuck, that's awesome. Yeah. I love capitalism.
Yep. So basically, we work for Grumps, and then... why did I bring this up? What?
And then we quit, and then just... Now we're still doing Super Mega.
Mm-hmm. But there was a reason I said this ties into the story.
You guys connected? You went, you were going to, I mean, I don't know. You were living with Markiplier. I've never watched Markiplier. Maybe that's what you were talking about. Never watched Game Grumps either.
I feel like a damn fool.
I fucked you up a little bit.
Do you remember what I was saying or why I brought this up?
You brought up the Game Grumps for a specific reason?
No, it was.
I'm trying to help you
it
out.
Was, it was something, it, Game Grumps. It was something. It was what you were saying before I jumped in.
Before you interrupted him.
Carl Jacobs is from Charleston as well.
Yeah, dox okay. him right
well,
now.
Well, you know, we were the two biggest YouTubers from South Carolina, and then Carl Jacobs, who actually I knew before he did the YouTube stuff.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
How?
My friends.
Judo?
No. My friend, he doesn't do YouTube stuff, but they were like best friends growing up. Oh. And I would go, I was friends with his older brother, and I would go to their house to hang out and get drunk, and Carl Jacobs would be over there hanging out with, before he did YouTube stuff.
Did you know his dad's a judo champion?
Really?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah. Not know that.
National champion.
Judo champion, superstar. What's Carl Jacobs' kid going to be?
He dethroned us,
though, as the most popular YouTubers from South Carolina. So I'm not, it's I don't have a chip up. On my shoulder about it, but.
Okay. Well, next time he's around, I'm gonna bring this up to him.
Please.
Like, how fucking dare you?
Please.
Messed up.
Let's go, Matt. Who?
Can we cancel him?
Yeah.
Can we do something so we can reclaim our?
Absolutely. Okay. I'm on board. I will do that for you guys.
Cancel Carl.
Even though I do love Carl, but fuck him.
Thank you.
It's over. Ride or die. Okay, so you guys make some political commentary, some political jokes. Let's talk about it.
Sure, yeah.
All right.
So 2016 era, you're already at this point, you're Game Grumps in 2016.
2016,
we started 2017 at Game Grumps.
That's right. Okay.
No, we started 2016. Yeah.
It was Super Mega.
Yeah, but then we started Game Grumps in 2016 as well. Later in the summer, yeah.
How would you describe your commentary or your political leanings?
So it's kind of like, you know, moved around a little bit over the years, just because I guess it's like going through your 20s, you just kind of...
Like my early 20s, I would say like still like politically, I've remained more left-leaning, but I think like in personality, definitely my early 20s, I would come across probably more right-leaning or just right-adjacent or something.
Yeah, because we were doing a lot of edgy comedy. And well, there was a big period where we were like those guys that were like, yeah, we're not afraid to say it. And the SJWs.
Yeah, that was the big one. The SJWs.
Like, SJW. But that's like, I feel like that was everyone on YouTube at a certain point. It felt like, except for, you know, I was working at the Young Turks at the time. So everyone was like, oh, these guys are the pussy SJWs. We were the guys that everyone was you guys were pointing to and being like, those guys fucking suck.
Probably.
Yeah.
Oh, I made a song about SJWs.
You did?
It's not on YouTube.
Fuck.
That's because it's very, is it not?
No, I took it
did
down.
Did it not get re-uploaded?
Yeah, it probably did, but I No. I know. I look at it and I just cringe.
It's really bad.
It's not even that it's necessarily like...
It's offensive. It's pretty offensive.
Yeah, it is. I'm remembering now, actually. We don't need to pull it up. Really I was 19. I was...
You're the one who brought it up.
Yeah, you brought it up.
No. Okay. Let's just bleep it out. No, but yeah, we were pretty like anti-SJW. And then now, you know, it's kind of... It's...
You love the SJWs.
I love SJWs as one myself. No, but now we're I would say very left leaning, and we've
always been left leaning. But I would say there was a point where like the left was affecting YouTube,
and now we're essentially leftists.
Who was the worst like right wing commentator that you watched on YouTube? Sargon of Akkad.
I remember there was a phase like probably. Where I would watch Sargon, I watched The Amazing Atheist back in the day.
Isn't he like, I mean, I don't know too much about those guys, but like, wasn't he like also, didn't he make a heel turn? He was like, he's like kind of leftist as well.
I can't remember.
Or I think he is now.
A lot of people have.
He got in trouble for like, not in trouble, but he stuck a bunch of things up his ass.
I do remember that. I remember seeing
and it got leaked or something.
That was another era of you. Keemstar did that.
Keemstar did that?
Didn't he like... Didn't he like go up to a tailpipe or something of a car, or was that fake?
No. There's this guy that looks like Keemstar, and there's videos of him like there's one where there's like a big dildo on a railroad track, and he's like dressed except with no pants, and he's like riding it.
That's not Keemstar.
And there's one where the dildo is on the back of a car, and he's like looking at the camera doing that. And if you tweet that at Keemstar, he instantly blocks you.
He's blocked me a long time.
Blocked you?
So he blocked me and then unblocked me. Because I ratioed him so hard that I think he like broke up with his girlfriend.
I think most people can ratio Keemstar.
It's really easy to ratio Keemstar.
He has like no fan base. It's a very strange thing that it's just he's this media demon that's been able to survive everything.
Everything. And like
multiple
he's still,
times been banned off YouTube.
Still has sponsorships, like everything.
Yeah.
And he doesn't like I don't know if he I've never met a Keemstar fan. Everyone knows who he is and he's an entertaining guy to watch. His show is
You're a fan. You're a fan of drama. You're a Drama Alert head.
Maybe I'm a fan.
What the fuck? You are the Keemstar fan.
I don't watch Drama Alert anymore, but it's like, I mean, there is an entertaining aspect to Keemstar, and that's why people keep up with him, because he's like, he wants to piss people off because it gets clicks. And
yeah.
Well, I mean, we were introduced to him also, and like, he was reporting on, one of our friends passed away, and he reported on it. And then right after reporting on it, he was like, and just remember... We're almost at like 500,000 subscribers. Like,
goes straight in. And that's how we found Keemstar, was when he reported on our friend's death.
That's wild.
But he made the crux of the story not about our friend's death, but about how Markiplier is taking a short hiatus because of our friend's death.
And
how to get the clicks.
Yeah.
I was put on Watch Mojo because you know how Watch Mojo makes like a top 10 like saddest videos. Well, they made one that was a top 10 saddest.
Really? That's kind of dark.
It was like top 10 saddest YouTube videos or YouTube controversy, whatever the fuck. And I'm in the honorable mentions.
Right, because basically...
Wait, that's even worse.
No, it is.
You weren't sad enough?
I like, without going...
But Mark was in for the same thing that happened, because our friend passed away, and so they gave me the honorable mention, but they gave Mark an actual spot on the list for the same event.
Because, right, because basically, like, without going into it too much, like, our friend passed away in 2015, and he worked with us with Mark as well, and, you know, he was part of the sketch. You know,
he was with Syndigo. Yeah. He's the one that...
So when he passed away, so Ryan had to announce that, you know, the channel wouldn't be continuing. And he made a video, a very, like, teary, just very real video. Like, no dramatics or anything, just...
I recorded with, like, my MacBook. I just went on the photo like, hey, booth app, probably.
And Mark also did a very teary video talking about it. And so Mark's got in there, but Ryan's at the end... They took the video down, actually, because Ryan called it out, but there's just a screenshot where it's just Ryan sitting on his couch with tears in his eyes, and it just at the bottom has the Watch Mojo logo and says honorable mention.
I can find it real quick, I bet you.
They took the video down. Just giving an honorable mention. It's like, guys, my friend died.
I mean, just the fact that you made a top 10 saddest YouTube videos alone is just deranged, okay? Oh, man, I love that. That's, fuck.
You ruined their company with that, Ryan.
Well, it's still on their website, right?
Is it?
Because they took it down from the YouTube channel because I made a meme about it on Twitter.
He just posted the screenshot.
And I was like, that's appropriate.
Thanks, guys.
That's wild. Now I kind of want to watch the video, but it's fucked up. Let's not do it. Never mind.
Let's pull it up.
Yeah, let's pull that traumatic. No, don't pull it up.
He was going for it. He's like,
Marsh was like, that's content. Let's do it.
That would get the clicks.
Yeah.
Would you give him an honorable mention?
What? I would make you the number one.
You.
I have.
Redemption arc.
Yeah, there you go. I don't know. I can't even think of like what I would consider to be like a really sad video I've watched on YouTube. I wish I was more in tune.
I got a screencast there.
That's a great screenshot.
Oh my God. Well, you had a glow up.
Thank you.
That's
you
what
did,
I
did, right?
You kind of look. Oh, you were doing that thing where you just didn't grow your mustache.
Yeah. Well, I had trouble for a bit just actually being able to.
See that?
Yeah. I had a chin strap for a good bit.
You did the classic. Wait, which camera should I show this to? That one? You had the classic. You can't even tell probably from here, but you had the classic, like, I can't grow a mustache, so I'm just going to grow the chin strap.
Really being roasted for this video.
And
this is
video about my friend's death.
He's grieving right here. Why are you just roasting his facial hair?
This is why I got the honorable mention, dog.
Yeah, honestly, Ryan, if you had grown it out, you might have been like top five.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I can't grow facial hair, so I mean, yeah. I'm 26 and I can't.
That's not true. I can see the stubble.
You try to grow it out, and every time you get it to a good point, you shave it before I can see it and applaud you because I'm the only one that supports it.
I support it.
Thank you.
I'm on board. You can put Rogaine. Did you know that?
Yeah, but it takes months. I have put Rogaine on before.
You have?
I have, and it...
Are you going to pull out a photo right now?
Yeah.
Show me your facial hair?
Yeah, check this out.
Okay, I'm on board. I like it.
Maybe it'll take the weight off of me.
I saw a lot of
dudes
in there. What's going on?
Here we go.
I do not have them on Discord.
That's the best I can do.
God damn.
It's really fair, but yeah, I can dye it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. At the airport.
There you go.
Hey, Ryan, this is the best.
You didn't want to go in on
what?
His facial hair situation?
No,
I mean mine's a lot of bad. He's like, oh, this is solid.
No.
you got like Al from Al's Toy Barn goatee going on.
What's up with your face?
I look like I...
Why are you doing that face?
It's like a cart, like an anim. I work at like an animation studio.
You're like,
no, oh, right. I was at the airport and I was really tired and I was like,
looking kind of sexy in this. That was the vibe from your face.
I was also drunk. I was at the airport.
Yeah,
really, the only thing to do at the airport is get drunk.
True.
Miss your flight. Well, I didn't miss my flight that time though.
Yeah, well,
I can't take
Muhammad Atta would
a few
have a
months.
Different opinion on what you can do at the airport. But
I'm not him. So
yeah, exactly. Not many are. Okay, we might have to cut that actually. Okay. I should stop making 9/11 jokes on August.
Yeah, well,
that's
we'll
the last time I got canceled.
Podcast. Yeah, we could talk about 9/11 on our podcast.
Okay, perfect. I get canceled every August.
Because
last August, I bought a house. The house that you're in right now. The $700 million mansion.
Nice.
Yeah.
We're here in the socialist mansion.
Yeah.
We're here in the one that... Did Fox News get mad about it?
Fox News, it was more so like Twitter outrage that Fox News was like, isn't this crazy? Look at these leftists being crazy at one of the other lefties. Ben Shapiro was really mad about it, though.
Was mad that you had a...
Yeah, he was like, haha, grifter. We got him.
Is his house? His house is probably like $8 million.
Oh, dude, for sure. But of course, he's right wing. So
yeah.
He's ongoing. Capitalism's awesome.
Yeah.
We just rent.
Yeah. Broke boys.
Well, I like to support landlords.
Yeah.
My landlord's actually really tight.
Really?
Yeah.
It's Markiplier.
Gives me a good deal.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Great landlord, yeah.
The reason why I originally brought up Markiplier is because they constantly fucking say, I don't even think I look like him. I think he's like a good looking dude, but I don't think I look like him. But people will always be like, Markiplier is if Hassan was good. And it'll always be like some random fucking account and it like pops off. Everyone is like, who's a Markiplier fan, either who doesn't know who I am or fucking hates me, will be like, yeah, you're right. Markiplier is such a good leftist. Hassan isn't. And I'm like, dude, this guy's like a quadrillionaire. Like, what do you mean? Like, anyway.
It's probably because you're both just hunks, honestly.
A couple of hung hunks.
Thank you.
You know?
Well, we don't know about you. We know about him.
I mean, yeah, he does have a big... Dude, I feel at this point he's like...
Every podcast they go on, they talk about me and they bring up how big my penis is.
Is that what he sounds like?
I'm tired of it.
Is that what he sounds like?
He's famous for his voice, yeah.
Oh, it's like this?
It's really...
He's got a girthy voice?
Yeah, it's like, hello, everybody. My name's Markiplier.
What about his penis? It's girthy?
Yeah. Yes.
God damn.
We never saw the flesh of it, but he was getting out of the pool once, and Ryan and I.
That's what it looks like, flaccid.
He might have been erect. I don't know. Maybe because he was swimming with us. I'm not sure.
Well, still, even then,
impressive. Regardless, it's a summer.
Sometimes you get hard. Sometimes you get hard when you're swimming with the boys.
It happens, man.
Yeah, it's not.
Swim past the pool jet by accident. Whoops.
Yeah. No, for sure. Oh my God, when I was younger. Yeah, that's not even.
I think everyone has the exact same story.
Yeah, that's like you just unlocked a core memory that I had shut off in my brain.
Disney World's Polynesian Resort.
that's where you got your rocks off. Public pool, okay. Kind of.
I was a kid. Well, no, it's very public pool.
Yeah,
it's like a mini water park. Oh, I was Jesus. A kid. I didn't get my rocks off. You get a little.
Yeah, you're like, whoa, what's this about?
I mean, Family Guy even has a joke about it, where Stewie does it. That's how you know it's not weird. It's mainstream.
Yeah, no.
Did you ever have that pool experience?
Yeah, tell us your pool experience.
You know what I'm talking about?
Are you talking about when the jet hits your
pee-pee?
Yes.
Yeah.
Where you're like holding on to the front of the pool like this,
and you're trying to like play it cool. I know.
You're just chilling.
Like, oh, I'm just taking a relaxing right now.
Yeah. Suspiciously, right near the cool. The
probably work as a good bidet, honestly.
Yeah.
What is it?
Oh, I just took a shit. Let me go jump in the pool real quick and
use the jet to clean my asshole.
Yeah, I feel that. That's
Do you have any of those jets in your $20 million pool?
I do have jets in my pool.
You have a jet? Private jet?
No.
I saw you on it with David Dobrik.
Multiple. Okay, I told you about that.
No, I saw.
I told you about that. I wanted you to keep it private, we talked about it on stream. But yeah, I did do that. I went on a private jet with them. How was
the experience? Was it like a party atmosphere?
No, not really. I think it was everyone was tired from Coachella. I never understood and he might be like a really nice guy, so I don't know. But like, I was really taken aback by the fact that there was like these young, my age or a little bit younger dudes there, and then there was just like one guy. Who's like 45 year old? Like he's like a dad.
Jeff Wittich?
Jeff's
the homie.
I'm thinking of some other dude from Vine.
No, Jason.
Jason.
Oh,
Nash.
Yeah,
Jason. Yeah, that's what it is. The J name.
And I was like, what's up? Like, doesn't it seems kind of out of place?
Like the 45 year old dude hanging out with
what's going on there?
When I'm 45, I hope to be hanging out with young influencers and reliving my 20s.
When he was on Vine. There was like when I first saw him, I thought that he just had like a disease that made him look older, and he was like the same age as everyone. Because I was like, why would he be hanging?
That's probably
out?
What
and
I
that's
would
why,
kids.
And that's why no one's bringing it up, right? Like that's what you thought, because like no one wants to be like fucked up about it.
If he has something going on, that's his personal.
No, I think
he's 19.
I think he's just like he's old. Wait, how old is Jason Nash? Can you look?
Wish that he tried to play it off though. He's like, I'm 19. Yeah. What?
Yeah, I have a disease.
49?
Oh my God, he's about to be 50.
Dude, he was born in 1973. He was born right after the Vietnam War ended.
So he was hanging out with like 17, 19-year-olds as a 40-year-old?
Hung out with 17, 19-year-olds?
Yeah. 17 of them.
It's better than 19 17-year-olds.
That's true. Unless he had the card.
That's true.
If he had the laminated card, that's fine. Everyone would be like, oh, fuck, he has a laminated card.
In place of his driver's license where they keep it.
Well, all I'm saying is Axl Rose.
I kind of want to go back to that, actually, because that was wild. Michael Bay did that. Why? Like,
I guess he felt a really strong calling to make it clear that you're allowed to have sex with a 17-year-old in a specific state.
He's like, okay, just in case something comes out, I just wanted to have this on the record.
Yeah.
He's like, look at my movie, Your Honor.
Because then everyone would totally be like, oh, I know Michael Bay fucked that 17-year-old, but he put that in the movie.
Michael Bay will be in court and be like, and guess what?
He pulls out the movie, Your Honor, and shows the
everyone's
scene.
Like, yeah, that's just like the Transformers movie.
Got like a plastic laminated one, like official fine.
Got
print.
A gold plated on his house.
Because that's so specific when you do that in a movie. It just like reminds me of like Zelda or like any other like Japanese shows where they will be like, this person, don't be fooled, is exactly 17. And I'm like, why did you have to do that? You drew this person. You could have said that they're 19. Nothing would change from the narration or the storyline if the person is 19 instead of 17, but they're like 17.
I watched Tangled last night, and
do they do that in Tangled?
Well, they make it very clear that she's 17, but she's about to turn 18. They have a lot of feet in that movie. I noticed that.
Like, Dan Schneider?
No, he didn't have any part in Tangled. That was John
Michael
Lasseter.
Bay.
It was Michael Bay did Tangled. Yeah. No, Dan Schneider, though. I've been trying to buy Jeanette McCurdy's book because I want to read it, but every time I go to Barnes & Noble, they don't have it.
What is it, like sold out?
Yeah.
You got to be able to buy it online or something. I want to get the audio book.
I want to support local stores, I'm going to Barnes & Noble.
The most shocking part about that is that you read books.
I haven't read a book in...
I was about to say, are you
Well, shocked? No...
We've read our own book.
Yeah, we wrote a book. We had to read it like legit like 8 or 9 times.
During the audiobook process?
No, during the editing process.
Oh.
So it would be like we get to the office, like, all right, let's read our book again, all like 180 pages. Just sit down and
fine tune it, really make it a work of art.
Yeah, it's a
lot of Italophobia in there, I heard.
A lot, yeah. And a lot of basically the premise is that Bin Laden actually never died.
Oh. And, okay.
It was a lie that the Obama administration came up with to win re-election. But basically...
So it's a book about truths. Okay, got it.
Yes, and then basically him and his Al-Qaeda goons end up kidnapping an elite team of SEALs, Navy SEALs, and recruited to go save them.
Did you know that those guys... I mean, was Robert O'Neill, a.k.a. Mick Booyah on Twitter, who fucking weirdly follows me, I don't know why.
Is he the SEAL that killed Osama?
Okay. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
The man that pulled the trigger and killed Osama bin Laden follows you on Twitter.
Technically, yes. But technically, he lied. A lot of those Navy SEAL books are all just full of lies. They lie about all the shit that they didn't actually do.
There's one, Lone Survivor, I remember.
That's
reading.
A lie, too. Dude. Yeah.
It's Mark Wahlberg. He did that.
Yeah. No. Mark Wahlberg actually did that just to recreate it.
Listen, if I had been there, things would have been a lot different.
Are you talking about 9/11?
Yeah, but also in that situation.
Because he did say that about 9/11.
Yes, he did.
Famously.
Also, if the terrorists were Asian, he would have probably
he would have stopped
more.
It a lot quicker.
Oh, 100%.
They were Vietnamese? Yeah. 100%.
He's like the natural predator. That's why. Like, he sees an Asian person, he just pops off.
Remember when...
Which is weird that they prosecuted him for that, actually. Because, you know, he's just...
Did they prosecute him for that stuff?
Yeah, he had to do it. Did they prosecute him for blinding a man in a hate crime?
With a big piece of plywood?
Yes, I'm pretty sure they did.
Okay, but we're all capable of change here.
Yeah,
okay?
Of course.
It was different back then.
I speaking of famous people that we've seen, I used to play basketball near Brentwood, like one of the public parks there, and he would always bring his kids to play baseball there.
Mark Wahlberg?
Yeah. And I played basketball with Adam Sandler. I have a funny Adam Sandler story.
No way.
Is he good at basketball?
Adam Sandler is decent at basketball.
He dresses like he plays basketball.
Yeah. The funny Adam Sandler story was, like, we were all super stoked that Adam Sandler was there. Because, like, I'm, like, new in L.A. I'm like, wow, this is just like Entourage. You see famous people everywhere. That was my reference point for Los Angeles' Entourage. We're playing basketball. And there's, like, this young kid who's, like, 16, 17. And everybody knew who Adam Sandler was. But he clearly didn't. So when we're like dabbing each other up, you're like, hey, I'm Hassan, whatever. We're handshaking. And he's doing it. And then the kid walks up to him and he's like, hey, I'm Hank. I'm just making this name up. I don't remember.
Jank.
And he doesn't say what his name is. And the kid's like, what's your name? And he's like, come on. Come on, kid. Don't do that. Don't he like straight up was like, don't do that.
Tell me.
No, literally. And I was like, I was shocked. It was so awkward.
How do you not know Adam Sandler, though?
I mean, but like he's 17. Adam Sandler wasn't even doing the Netflix stuff yet.
He didn't grow, up with Billy Madison.
Yeah. I didn't either, Big technically. Daddy.
Grown-ups? Grown-ups
Big Daddy
too?
Is one of my favorite movies of his.
I've never understood Adam Sandler. I liked Mr. Deeds.
Did you like Uncut Gems?
Is Mr. Deeds?
Oh, no, that's different. That's new Adam. That's
Mr. Deeds
great.
The one where he has like a black foot that he can like...
I think so.
In the trailer, he just like puts a poker, you know, like a fireplace. He shoves it into his foot.
Really?
But I never understood like the golf one, like I just, or Waterboy.
I saw that for the first time like a week ago.
Waterboy was.
How did you feel about that?
It wasn't awful. I had a decent
But it wasn't
time.
Like fucking mind-bogglingly good.
No, well, a lot of people love Waterboy. That's probably like my least favorite.
I liked it when I watched
and
it.
And Hubie Halloween. I did not like Hubie Halloween.
That's Adam Sandler?
Yeah.
So no, sorry. For some reason I confused it with some Luke recent Ferrell? Animated Halloween movie.
No, that was his Netflix movie.
Oh,
movie
okay.
Halloween.
Oh yeah, the animated one was not Halloween. It was Christmas. No, it was like the Jewish Christmas or something.
No, that's I like Eight that Crazy movie. Nights. That movie is.
Are you talking about Hotel Transylvania being the animated movie?
I don't know, dude. I didn't. I'm thinking of an animated Halloween movie.
All right.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to take you down this path and confuse you. And I really hope that
I'm easily confused.
I know. Yes. I'm sorry for doing that to you.
It's fine.
I'll move on.
Yeah.
Andrew Tate's banned off Facebook and Instagram.
Amen.
Let's talk about it.
That's right.
What do you guys think about that? You're on YouTube. You gotta fucking be like, dude, censorship is unacceptable.
Wasn't he saying that? Like, I don't know. I hear a lot of talking points, but I'm gonna be honest. I have not watched Andrew Tate, but I have heard that he's.
Yeah, you
like,
do look like a beta soy boy.
I haven't watched Andrew Tate either. I mean, I've seen little clips, but
yeah. You don't watch Andrew Tate. You live it.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it's supposed to be.
That's how I recently got a. Got some pussy because of Andrew Tate.
Fuck yeah.
You know?
That has never happened.
No, that's not true, and it happened to me last week.
Not that like you've never gotten pussy. I'm sure you may or may not have gotten it, but no one has ever watched Andrew Tate and actually gotten laid, I don't think.
I don't know. Check the comments.
I don't know, Hassan. You live here in your little $20 million bubble.
Yeah.
And all you hear is your own echo. So maybe if you tried some of the things he talked about,
yeah, like
maybe
beating, you go, it's beating women.
Okay, is it true?
Choking them.
Is there an some actual like thing that. Where he said, I saw H3 say it, where
yes,
he's like, women deserve to be raped?
That's some of the things that he said. Yeah.
Some of it. It's not all
he,
of it.
He says women are property. If he has a girlfriend and she like has an OnlyFans, he would never let that happen. But if he were to let that happen, then like... She would have to give him, because she's his property, she would have to give him 100% of the profits. Or maybe if he's feeling good about it, he'll give like a 20-80 with 80% going to him.
Just a different opinion.
Didn't he also backtrack and say like, just kidding, this is just the personality I'm putting up. I'm putting up like a, it's me, but it's an exaggerated version of me.
Yeah, he did that when he got banned. Okay. He went on Aiden Ross's stream yesterday and he like basically.
Aiden Ross's stream?
Yeah, that's where you go.
What a crossover.
That's where you go when you like want to let the people know.
Yeah.
I mean, he knows his target demographic. It's all like fucking 11-year-olds. So.
I love when Keemstar went on that Aiden Ross stream and everyone just goes like quiet.
Yeah. That was awesome.
Like the cringe.
Can we watch that?
It's called Keemstar Kills the Vibe.
That. Yeah, that's one of my favorite videos.
I think that.
Can we watch the train tracks one too?
Please, can we watch that?
I mean, we could. We can do that behind the paywall.
Yeah.
We can do that behind the paywall, but we're gonna, which will happen in a little bit. Should we? Do we have to do two? I mean, we already have one.
There's two Keemstar.
No, I'm saying
videos.
Like the Chapo is already. Yeah. What do you mean? We just like throw it up whenever. Maybe.
Talking bit.
I don't know. We could talk about this after.
It's rude to do that in front of guests.
Well, the way we normally talk. Wait, before you start it, because this is gonna be cut out anyway. No, the way we normally do it is we just stream. I mean, not stream. We shoot an unpaywalled part of the podcast. For an hour, and then another like 35, 45 minutes of like,
paywall
content. Okay, we can do that. Cool. But we already have extra episodes that we cut. All right.
Yo, you're in trouble.
Why?
Oh, shit. That crypto shit.
Is this edited?
Like, did they add silence? Or no. Is this...
Hey, Steve, get his ass from right now.
What's up, buddy? How you doing?
You good?
I just did a podcast with Tana Mojo. It was so raw, so real.
Hey.
Got the...
Hey, Mr. Gemini.
Jesus, bro, you scared the...
I think you should box. Here's why. You have natural energy. They see it in the stream, right? You need that. Like, you have natural energy. You got some cold energy about you. Like,
bro, the dude sitting next to him is like, not a fan.
No. No. Like, killer
energy about I wonder why.
I'm 39. She's 20,
can't think of any reasons why.
Like, wait. Go back. This part's great. Wait. I'm 39.
Fucking no emotions, like killer energy about you. I'm 39, she's 20, so he came at me like calling me a creep or whatever. And he was like saying that I had like a little dick, my dick didn't work as shit.
Am I right, fellas?
What do you think about that?
No, what's even worse is every positive.
Yo, he legitimately went on his show. This motherfucker went on his show, he said it was on antidepressants, and the side effects were that he didn't have feeling in his dick.
Is he talking about Ethan?
Projection.
Yes.
He was trying to put that on me.
That was when they had the beef about.
I'm focusing.
The lie detector, the hood nigga lie detector, the test.
That's the best part.
Calm down, please. Calm down. It's gonna be-
like, how afraid is he of every. It's just the absolute.
Keemstar dresses like a like if you like had a little toddler boy and had to dress him up for like a costume party as like cool, and then just like put him in like a time machine and blew him up a little bit.
I'm just thinking about cool toddler costume. He has the fakest beard. Why does his beard look like that, man?
If I could grow it, I would.
No, you wouldn't.
Yeah, if I could have the gnome.
To be fair, you literally don't need to have a real beard to have it look like that.
No, it looks like a Lego piece you can pop off. Yeah. Like it looks like you just boop, like he gets home and he like puts that one, gets like a clean one, pops it back on.
I want to see him without a beard so bad. I mean, there's photo. Can you look up
someone Keemstar had to beardless? Face apt him or something?
No, there's Keemstar beardless photos, I think, back when he used to say the N-word all the time.
Oh, back when he had like his backwards hat, God. His troll phase.
No. There's one that's real. The one, like, look down. Yep, there, you're on it. Oh my God.
Daniel Keem.
And then there's one with a beanie right under it. To look to your right, where he's wearing the beanie. Yeah.
Ah, dude.
Yeah, I get why he's doing that. I get why he's got the beard going.
Like the eye squints.
Yeah. That's how he gets all the 17-year-old girls. Yeah. Luckily, he has the laminated card. Yep.
Dude, he's trying to roast me. She's 20. I'm double her age, and he's trying to roast me?
Yeah, what the
dude,
fuck?
Dude, he's on antidepressants, and his dick, he doesn't have feeling in his dick.
That was a great own. I felt the burn pretty hard on that.
Did you take antidepressants?
Yeah, fucked up. Well, he has a famous...
The beer thing?
I love that. Wait, I quit my... Keemstar beer?
The tweet? I quit my antidepressants after I read that tweet. Yeah. I threw them in the trash, and I got myself a fucking Miller Lite.
No, it's just a tweet. Just look up Keemstar beer. Antidepressants or depression.
People really like the dog tweet too.
It's one of the best.
Yeah, that one. Documented mental illness isn't real. Yep, there it is. The drug companies invent all these illnesses so they can sell drugs to morons. Social anxiety 100% is a fake invented illness so they can sell you drugs and make millions. He's anti-capitalist.
Yeah, king. Fucking base, dude.
Yeah, stop being weak. Society's literally going to die if you keep this bullshit up. Meanwhile, Keemstar, very strong.
Very mentally
stable.
Yeah.
Real talk, if you suffer from panic attacks and you're old enough to drink, the best way to stop a panic attack real quick is to just have a sip of beer.
You only need like three sips.
I love the way the cadence of that tweet is so, it's so well constructed.
It's like he has that one and then he's like, okay guys, but real talk.
You only need like
just three sips.
Just three sips. Just three little sips and you're fine. Man, what a fucking legend Keemstar is.
God. He has the same views on pharmaceuticals that Tom Cruise has.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, I have those views as well.
Just
yeah.
be happy.
Yeah.
Not with the fucking depression shit. Your life is fine.
Yeah.
Everyone, or as my dad said to me when he found out I started taking antidepressants in high school and going to therapy, he goes, son, everyone gets sad sometimes.
There's no need to be a little bitch about it.
Be a little pussy about it.
That's good life lessons right there.
No, and then I said...
Keemstar is a dad.
He is, yes.
Oh, God.
He has a child.
That's terrifying.
I don't know. What? She's not like a little kid anymore. Like
no, she's like 14.
Yeah, like he has like a teenage daughter. Imagine like she goes to school and it's like talking about your parents. Like, what do your parents do? It's like, oh, my dad's Keemstar.
That's, you will not be able to extract that information out of me in a torture facility.
Keemstar does kind of strike me as the type of guy that would like buy alcohol for like 15-year-olds.
He's the type of dude who would ask his daughter's girlfriends, like, you know, to wear, you know, revealing clothing.
Do you think she's embarrassed of him, or do you think that she is just going to be like a little Keemstar 2.0?
Think she's probably embarrassed because okay. It's like Ted Cruz's daughters. They're all so like 12, 13, 14. They're like big Minecraft stans. And yeah. They just don't like their father.
Have you seen the
videos?
The video, the
behind
video?
The scenes shit.
Yeah.
Or
he goes in for a kiss at one of them.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's a great one.
What about
yeah.
you think Baron Trump like watches YouTube a lot? Because he seems like the type of kid that would be playing Minecraft.
He does like Minecraft.
That's is that confirmed?
He wore like a Minecraft shirt, right?
Maybe, I think so, maybe.
It was like
he definitely plays Minecraft.
Yeah, I mean, he's like, what, 17? 6'8".
Dude, like Trump's pretty tall, too. Like, Trump's what, 6'2"?
How tall are you? I'm 6'4".
You're 6'4"?
Yeah.
So, Baron Trump is 4 inches taller than you?
Yeah, no, he's fucking huge.
Jesus.
He's so tall.
He's
6'7".
Dude, that's the next president, dude. I mean, future president. Look at that. Look at that photo.
Jesus Christ.
He looks like he could be a base groiper, though. Like, I think that's where he's headed.
He looks like some guy you'd like see at a club in Poland. Like, he's never said anything publicly. Like, do you think that... Do you think he watches you? Do you think he's watching this right now?
I fucking doubt it. Baron, if you're watching, you know, I don't know.
Come on the show.
Yeah, would love to have you, man. Would love to discuss. I'm a big fan of your father.
Look at that.
I'm fucking real president. Still the president. President.
Real question. Do you think, Ryan and I ordered them to raid Mar-a-Lago. They did. Do you think that anything... I lost all hope that anything would ever actually happen because there's always been so many things where it's like, oh, it's clearly like there's a criminal thing going on here. And then it's just like, nope. Like, nothing ever happens. Do you think anything, like, with the January 6th stuff, which we were not there, there were two guys that looked like us, and that's all I'm going to say about that. But basically...
What was your alibi for January 6th? What were you doing instead?
Let's plays?
Yeah. You can probably go watch some of them if you want. You haven't seen them, so...
Dude, you love them.
Now I kind of want to watch it. What's the...
Dude, we played the new Mario Kart maps. Every time you get hit with an item, you got to take a shot. You take 24 shots?
I took 24 shots, and then... they all left me alone as I was,
I had to go home. There were still three people there. They left you alone.
And they made sure I was on my back.
Yeah.
That's as
you need to be when you've had 24 shots of liquor.
That's all you need. Yeah. What do you mean?
Yeah.
That's cool. Okay. I'll look at that. I'll watch your Let's Plays.
On Patreon, it's me like throwing up.
Oh my God.
Like projectile vomiting for about like 20 to 30 seconds straight.
Wait, really?
Yeah. We were fucked. And he's in the living room with like a trash bag and a mail bin, and he is just fucking, it's like a fire hose. And I'm just standing there with
one spurt.
It's cool because we're going to recreate that behind the paywall on our Patreon.
Good time to
shift over to that part. I don't even know what to do with the outro in this.
Hey, let us handle this one. Yeah, Ryan?
You do it. You guys are professionals.
The outro?
The outro, guys.
Thank you for having us on for this portion of the podcast.
Just
because there is a better portion. Well, a better portion.
It's going to be better.
That you can pay money for.
Yeah.
How much money?
$5.
$5.
$5.
Yeah. Fear. Patreon.com/VRN. Oh yeah, dude. I literally told Marsh to look up everything the yard was doing. And I was just like, yeah, buy a subscription for 1 month only. Don't buy it for 2 months. You know, don't give them a single fucking dime. Steal all their fucking Patreon, ideas, and then we're going to do it. But better.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what everyone does.
Why, do they all steal it from you?
Yeah. We invented the $5 model.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we were the first ones to come up with the $5 business model.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much. Well, you'll be able to see all that next time. Yeah.
Oh, you can find us
on our channel.
Not in any pictures of January 6th.
No.
But our YouTube channel at Super Mega. It's just one word. People always mess it up in two words. One word, Super Mega. And Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff. Eli Rye McGee on Twitter and Twitch. Matt H. Watson on Twitter. And yeah.
All right.
Let's talk about some really fucked up shit now.
All right. Let's do it. We got held up at gunpoint when we were at USC.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Yeah, like...
I always thought, like, Andrew Tate kind of looks like Nick Kroll a little bit.
Yeah, he does.
Like, just, don't you think so?
I think
kind
so.
Of.
Like, you shave Nick Kroll, we could watch the Keemstar train video.
That's a good way to end it, man.
I do want to watch that. Can we find that?
No, it's not going to be on YouTube.